Hello, 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 hello. I have a new model here with me today. A brand new model. Is it alright if I say your name? Her name's Anna. And I'm going to do just a trigger assortment of random, relaxing, classic in-person triggers. I think I'm gonna have it be one in a series of my stress relief medleys. You know, just a little assortment of triggers that fit nicely together in person. So I was sort of talking to Anna a little bit earlier about what she might find relaxing. And usually I draw upon, you know, childhood experiences and, you know, like when I was given the example that when I go to sleep, as a kid, my mom would sometimes just play with my hair or just light reassuring touches until I fell asleep. In my mind, touch is a really powerful tool that we have to help cope with and reduce anxiety. I think on an instinctual level, from a young age, I would often be, I say I fidget a lot, but I sort of mean that I, you know, often just do self-soothing gestures as a way to calm myself down. And I think it can be really nice. I treasure a lot of early memories I have with my little friends where I could be giving and receiving touch. And that would often include, you know, me and my friends playing with each other's hair. Maybe an older girl knew how to braid and she was showing us. Or maybe it was reading time and we were just bored and antsy, and someone's like, "Oh, can I play with your hair?" And then you'd be like, "Yes, yes, please." And so I think I was trying to explain a little bit what to expect because she's a bit new to ASMR. And I think that ASMR is I think ASMR can mean many different things, but a lot of triggers that I enjoy involve visual ASMR. That just means that the video and not just the audio is triggering ASMR. And I think that a lot of that comes from mirror neurons. So when you watch somebody else receive gentle caresses, you sort of feel, a part of you feels that as well. And it can help relax you. So I watch a lot of videos like where it's just somebody playing with a friend's hair, or I really enjoy watching people receive very light, gentle touches on the skin. it can be either really softly with the fingertips or with brushes, and I have a couple brushes with me here today. And I've heard a lot of people hypothesize why these sorts of gestures are so soothing, and the value that we get out of non-sexual touch, and why do we do it, you know? We often associate touch with romantic or sexual intimacy, so it's hard to understand its purpose and meaning outside of that. But I think there is something very instinctual about, you know, just intimate, but platonic touch. You know, you think of families and a mother and a child, and the studies that are done on children who don't receive loving touches. Those that do fare a lot better in the long run. So there's something powerful there in touch alone, in and of itself, and not as a means to any end. I have also heard people hypothesize it's like how we come from monkeys, and monkeys will often be sort of like playing with each other's hair like that. They're like rooting around for bugs, and even just as a grooming behavior, as both social and health benefits for monkeys, so who knows? So our distant ancestors, so maybe it means something. Anna was telling me as well that she does have a good memory that I also share of somebody doing the egg on the head and letting the yolk run down. My dad would do the egg on my head, and I would ask him to do it over and over again just because it was such a pleasant sensation. And then it runs down your arms and your back. Try to get behind you for an improved egg. So I can do that periodically. You get a little desensitized to it if you're doing it all the time, but I'll throw in some eggs here and there. It's really nice to do is, honestly, even for me, to just play with Anna's hair. It's so soft. Anna's hair is so soft, and it's so healthy. It's this beautiful blonde color. Known Anna for a while, well, you know, since college, which is a few few years now. For a while, Anna had very long hair. Or, well, I guess it's all relative. Compared to her hair now, it sort of went maybe like under your collarbones, even longer. Graduating, did you cut it yourself?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, Anna cuts it herself. Just part of why it's so impressive that it looks so good and it suits her so well. Anna has a very gentle presence as well, which is why I think she's fantastic to have in an ASMR video. I think, even if Anna's not always calm herself, she's typically a calming presence, you know? Because of course your internal world and external world are, you know, different, and I know it's not always easy. They're not always smooth sailing, but you have a very calming presence, you know? That's what I'm trying to say, without putting you in a box. Wow, I love your hair. Something I also like to do is just tucking people's hair behind their ears. I don't know what it is. It's like, there's something so neat about organized and precise, detailed. Very detailed motions like that tend to be quite relaxing. You know, I would get ASMR watching QVC commercials growing up, and when people are being very attentive to the details of a surface, I find that the forehead can be a particularly relaxing part. Maybe it's to do with the eyebrows as well, because I think we hold a lot of tension in our brow. Or at least I feel like I hold a lot of tension in my brow, and I find it really relaxing when I have a gentle reminder to relax my brow. So if you're watching, take this as a gentle reminder to try to relax the muscles of your forehead and your eyebrows. Try to relax all of the muscles in your face, your cheeks and your jaw. Your chin. I have some makeup brushes. Some makeup brushes that I freshly washed. So I just try to make sort of similar motions as I was with my hands, just slow, light, and I think I might mention this in like every video that I do like this, but one of the most fascinating things that I learned in my perception course was just that there's an optimal speed at which your sense receptors recognize a touch as a caress. I can't remember the exact pace, but it's your sense receptors, well, you have specific sense receptors to register soft caresses, and they are triggered with a certain speed of motion, which I just think is so cool that we really have that built into our very biology, to have comforting touch be a part of our chemistry, a part of our makeup. The nice thing about brushes too is I can sort of get even more into different nooks and crannies because I'm not worried about, you know, they're very soft and I don't have to worry about poking out an eye or anything. Because it's just the softest of brushes. For a certain part of your skin on your face.
Maybe the forehead.
Yeah.
The eye region.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, our eyes don't really get that many soft touches, you know. We're usually just rubbing our eyes or something like that. As well would have their early ASMR experiences with getting their makeup done, just for that reason of getting very soft brushes and touches, and also the personal attention aspect. There's a whole trigger that's just people giving and receiving personal attention. And so there's something about when somebody's completely focused on you that sort of optimizes a situation for ASMR potential. Like, there's a surprising amount of ASMR videos that are just people getting checked for lice, because that's like a very early experience of personal attention, and you have a nurse who's just solely focused on you, and you have the aspect of her playing with your hair, and or him or they. My nurse was a lady, so that's what I'm thinking of. So other situations like that are, going to the makeup counter, or getting your hair done, or of course, things like going to the spa just naturally pair well with ASMR. There's a lot of spa ASMR role plays. I've even seen ones that are sort of personal attention from, you know, other eras, like a lady in waiting dressed as a queen. People get really creative. It's wonderful. But everyone has different triggers, so for some people, it's really just about the sounds. And there'll be ASMR channels that just show you microphones with, you know, very specific tapping sounds or I'm gonna shift to a new brush. I'm gonna do a little egg yolk before I go. Let the yolk run down. So next I wanna try a brush that's a little less fluffy. It's still very soft. But it's a little more pointed. A little more concentrated. It's a bit more dense. The bristles are more densely packed. So each of these subtle differences in a brush will lend itself to a slightly different sensation. I like to do sometimes too is trace the face. So you go along the jawline, up past the ear, along the temple. Trace the eyebrows. The eyes themselves. Down the bridge of the nose. The skin under the eyes. And then down the neck slightly as well, extending the motion to the shoulders, back through the collarbones. And with this brush you can be more precise like this. Not that you couldn't trace with the other brush, but we have more of a point here. Even trace around Anna's necklace. It's very pretty. What's the necklace from?
Japan.
When did you get that?
We were visiting my brother there in 2018.
Wow. Is it a particular part? I want to go to Tokyo so bad.
Yeah.
In a little, I'll say, I'll have you turn around and we can do, write some letters on your back. We can give you a bit of a shoulder massage as well. Also give you the headphones and you could hear a little bit of what it sounds like on the mic. Okay. So we'll go ahead and do that. Okay. We have Anna's back, which is clearing off a little bit of her hair there. Anyways, we have Anna's back here, and one of the things Anna shared with me when I asked if she would do anything sort of fun and ASMR-like with her friends was that she would have people write on her back, or she would write on other people's backs and have them guess the letters. So I thought that we could do a little bit of that and then go from there. So I haven't even really thought through what kind of words I should write. So how about I'm thinking I can do some more light touches. Clean the canvas off. Okay. I can go again. Should I go letter by letter?
Yeah, maybe so.
Okay. It's completely random, so I'm not sure if that helps, but...
Okay.
Alright. How about that one?
Or?
Yes. Here, I'm gonna do it with a brush as well. This one's more pointed. Okay. So, you got R. Maybe you were second guessing yourself. Because there's no reason why I picked this word. Yes. rhino. You know what really happened? I started going, relax. And then I was like, that's too cliche. I thought, what's another R? So maybe I'll continue with that theme and just start with something really cliche and see where it takes me. Okay. Do you want to go letter by letter again?
Sounds good.
Okay. So, how about that?
See.
Yes. If it's harder to do it with this like fluffy brush,
okay.
Or easier, or the same.
I love the fluffy brush.
Isn't it nice? Do a little shoulder and back massage as well. So let me get your hair over here. There we go. by just getting your shoulders more used to my touch. Used to a touch with more pressure, since I've been giving such light touches. So I'm gonna start small and then go from there. In fact, I'll start at the neck here, right at the nape of the neck. This area actually holds a lot of tension, so we use it to, you know, hold our head up, which is very heavy compared to a lot of animals. So it's good to reduce some tension there. And I do that just by really softly, with my two pointer fingers, apply some light pressure just at the nape of the neck, and then can bring it down in wider motions to the side of the neck, on either side. And we can bring it down even further, using the spine to guide us. I like to do some small pressure points around the spine and then radiate it out from there with my thumbs. Make little circles with your fingers as well along the spine and just soften out the muscles, the tendons, the interstitial fluid. Just move around some of the lymph there. I do like to start around the spine, but again, you can radiate out further. These motions with my thumbs. Back up to the shoulders. Knead the shoulders, starting with them. This side, sort of feeling to see where there might be points where the muscle is denser, possibly more knotted, and then just very softly pressing into those areas and working out. We're just starting to work out, helping it along for the muscles to relax, to unclench, and to heal. Moving to the other shoulder. Do the same thing on this side, just start light where there's a little more give, knead in harder until you feel points that might need to be worked out. Huge network of muscles on our shoulders, from our neck, and we have our arms, we have our back. It's the nexus of so many important areas of the body. So we have a very complex network of ligaments and tendons and muscles and blood vessels, skin. And I can sort of alternate between a broader pressure to a more precise pressure. Area right behind the shoulder blades is also a place that tends to carry a lot of tension, so it can be a good place to gently work into. And again, I'll start on this side. Sorry guys for the cut. I had to change the memory card and battery pack, but I'm finishing up now with a massage. We were going around Anna's shoulder blades, and I would like to do the same to the other side so that we are even. So, do a little bit of that, and then say goodnight to you guys and try to take a piece of this relaxation with us from this session. And hopefully Anna will be back with us in the future for additional ASMR adventures. I have quite a few ideas in the pipeline and and always love to collaborate with my friends and loved ones. And again, I think that touch is very healing. We all could use some relaxation. We all could use a little bit of peace and calm. And Anna works very hard. I just hope that Anna was able to have a calm evening after a hard day of work, and that all of you were able to have a calm evening after a hard day of work. So, I will talk to you guys soon, and hopefully we can see more of Anna in the future. Let me know what aspects of the video you liked or what else you might want to see. And again, just have a peaceful rest of your day.